Good afternoon. On behalf of Michael's wife, Pamela, his sons, David and Justin, and their spouses and grandchildren, I welcome you and thank you for coming to honor and to celebrate the life of Michael Lynn Harwood. We come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. We ask God to grant us grace, that in pain we may find comfort, in sorrow hope, in death resurrection. When I was asked to lead a celebration of Mike's life, I was told he would not want us to make a fuss about him, and he would not want us to keep you here very long. I'm going to try to abide by both of Mike's wishes. I want to begin with a prayer that was written by a young firefighter in 1958. He had fought a tragic fire where three children lost their lives, and he wrote what came to be known as the Fireman's Prayer, as a prayer for his family, other firemen, and the families of the children. I believe Michael probably heard this prayer many times during his long firefighter career, as have the firefighters with us today. And perhaps he prayed something like this as he was rushing to a fire. The Fireman's Prayer. When I'm called to duty, God, whenever flames may rage, give me the strength to save some life, whatever be its age. Help me to embrace a little child before it's too late, or some older person from the horror of that fate. Enable me to be alert and hear the weakest shout, and quickly and efficiently to put the fire out. I want to fill my calling and give the best in me to guard my neighbor and protect his property. And if according to your will, I have to lose my life, please bless with your protecting hand my children and my wife. Amen. I want to follow this with a poem by an unknown author that may describe Michael's experience as he approached the pearly gates. A fireman knocked at the heavenly gate. His face was scarred and old. He stood before the man of fate for admission to the fold. What have you done, St. Peter said, to gain admission here? I've been a firefighter, sir, he said, for many, many years. The pearly gates swung wide as St. Peter touched the bell. Come in and choose your harp, my son. You've seen your share of hell. Michael was 79 years old when he passed away on December 19th after a brave battle with cancer. The family's very grateful that during his battle, he did not experience pain. He was at home, surrounded by his family, and lovingly cared for by the love of his life, his wife Pam, and best friend Shelby Primo. Mike was predeceased in death by his parents Bernard and Olga, brothers Tom and Jerry, and his best friend Mike, two dogs, Primo. Michael was born on July 9, 1941 in Woodstock, Illinois, to Bernard and Olga Harwood. He chose a life of service at a very young age when he enlisted in the United States Navy and served from 1958 to 1962. He served on the USS Essex during the Bay of Pigs conflict. On September 29, 1978, Pam and Mike were married. They built a wonderful and happy life together in the Crystal Lake, McHenry area, and later in Belvedere. During these years, he worked as a firefighter for the Crystal Lake Fire Department from 1970 to 1980. He then served as a firefighter for the state of Illinois, assigned to the state hospital in Elgin, Illinois, until his retirement. The beautiful thing, though, is Mike didn't just choose a life of service for himself, but by example, and perhaps some words, he instilled that same commitment to others in his two sons. David serves as a battalion chief for the McHenry Township Fire Protection District, and Justin serves as a firefighter EMT for the Harlem Roscoe Fire Protection District. This is truly a family committee committed to selflessly serving others. After retirement, Mike and Pam became snowbirds, traveling to Apache Junction, Arizona for 19 years. They had a beautiful fifth wheel RV that they lived in. They shared a love of the outdoors. In Arizona, Mike liked to go up into the mountains with his metal detector to see what he might discover. He also enjoyed panning for gold. Probably the best thing, though, was when he and Pam just climbed into the Jeep and went off-roading to see what they could discover or just enjoy being outdoors together. When they were back in Illinois, nothing brought Mike more enjoyment than being with his family and friends. Mike, Pam, and Shelby enjoyed many golf outings. He loved having his three granddaughters, Olivia Lynn and Abby, and Olivia Marie, over for sleepovers. The sleepover was always followed by Grandpa's special pancakes. The recipe was and remains a secret, but the memory of the special pancakes with Grandpa will never end. Pancakes were not Mike's only culinary specialty. Christine shared with me that Mike made a mouth-watering barbecue chicken that was unmatched and meant to be devoured. He had a special pan, a very old pan, that he always prepared the chicken in, and a list of ingredients that he never shared with anyone. The family has the pan, and Christine has been tasked with recreating the recipe. I suspect she will get some heavenly help with her project. Grandpa Mike was Cameron's best buddy, and they shared special outings to go for apple juice and French fries. What special times between Grandpa and his grandson to remember. Mike was a fisherman and loved taking his grandson Evan and sons David and Justin fishing. While the fishing was great fun, the time together was really the point of the outings. Although he wasn't a hunter, he thoroughly enjoyed hearing stories and seeing pictures of his grandson Evan's hunting with a shotgun and bow and arrow. Perhaps Mike's greatest joy, though, was just having a beer and listening to Dave and Justin's brotherly bantering. The bantering was always good-natured and brought a smile to his face. Michael understood the meaning of life. He knew and practiced the importance of love. He also had an appreciation for the cycles of life, knowing that for everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven, a time to be born and a time to die, a time to mourn and a time to dance. Mike enjoyed times of laughing, speaking, and embracing, but he also knew there would be times for weeping. We're thankful that Michael was created to live a life of love and service. I was not privileged to know Mike, but I do believe that if it's possible to know the Father through the sons, I know these things about Mike. He was respectful of everyone. He took care of others before himself. He didn't need to be in charge all the time, but wanted to have input from everyone when making an important decision. He knew how to listen to others. Mike knew the importance of having fun and laughing together. He was a kind man and he loved deeply. In essence, Michael Lynn Harwood was a good man. Learning about Mike's life reminded me of a poem by Joyce Greenville titled Sing Well. If I should die before the rest of you, break not a flower nor inscribe a stone. Nor, when I'm gone, speak in a Sunday voice, but be the usual selves that I have known. Weep if you must, parting is hell, but life goes on, so sing as well. I would like to close with a Psalm 23. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Would you please pray with me? Eternal God, we praise you for those dear to us, and we especially praise you for Michael Lynn Harwood, whom you have graciously received into your presence. To all of these, grant your peace and let perpetual light shine upon them. Into your hands we commend Michael in the sure and certain hope of resurrection to the eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. This includes our service. Thank you for being here. Because of COVID, the family has asked me to announce that there will not be a lunch or a gathering. And there will be an American Legion Military Honor Guard presentation, and you are welcome to stay for that presentation. We will remain inside for that. Thank you.
So folks, that'll be about 15 minutes. You're welcome to stay, or you can go ahead and if you have somewhere to go, you can go ahead and go. Thank you.
Yeah. Changing the pattern.
Yes.
The table, I don't know if she is trying to talk to you anymore. too, they got a phenomenal goal. CNC did it over, so pretty cool. They put it up.
Oh, yeah, it's going to make more to the long shed.
Oh, it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
It's not the problem, it's like it's really important.
Yeah.
But it's from.
That's, he found a video that had a guy that basically made like a magazine for he had a bunch of arrows in it, so you just throw them back, and you can shoot, and you throw them back.
So cool.
And it's like, it looks cool, but I feel like it would suck to shoot.
Yeah,
it would be super heavy. And just ended up sticking out there. Oh, I guess it was bad.
Yeah.
I don't know. I feel like it, maybe if you're like, just start shooting, I feel like in that situation, so you can hit it on the outside. It's like that the longer axle to axle goes, or the more forgiving goes, I can shoot better with those. And like, I need a longer axle to axle one because my draw length is long, so it doesn't punch the nut. But the shorter axle to axle goes are nice and loose.
So. Yeah, I didn't even get a chance to.
On behalf of the family, $350 for a crossbow. Exactly. But that crossbow is $800. So that, no, it's not. That's probably what she said. Yeah.
There's a place up there.
Back here.
I
If it's over, yeah.
Still walk right under this tree, the rest of the trees, and eat a lot.
Pete's still at the old five.
How you doing?
You're doing better. Look, I've got that knee in there. Got a bone spur on there.
You're in a room full of paramedics, I guess.
Every time it moves.
Folks, that concludes the service. Here with your.